When we think about strength in the animal kingdom, what comes to mind first? Gorillas, bears, this guy?
Or what about something smaller?
Smaller than that. Smaller than that, too. This is a microscopic image of one of the strongest natural materials in the world, a human hair.
Believe it or not, if you took all the hair from one person's head, it could support 12 tons. That's the weight of two elephants.
Yeah, but what makes hair so strong?
And whose is the strongest? Let's find out.
Human hair is comparatively pretty thin. Boars, horses, dogs, and other animals have hair with a greater diameter than ours. So the question is, does that mean it's going to be stronger or weaker? I mean, you would assume that thicker hair is stronger, right?
So we are here today to look at the strength of hair. We have human hair and horse hair, and we're trying to figure out how many strands of human hair it takes to beat one strand of horse hair.
Yeah, and to measure this, we're looking at something called tensile strength. In other words, how much weight the hair can hold before it snaps. The weight is pennies, and the hair that can hold the most pennies is the winner.
So here we have one strand of human hair, two strands of human hair, three strands of human hair, and one strand of horse hair.
Earmarks.
Get set.
Let's go.
That's one.
Imagine it snapped after that.
Oh gosh.
Two.
Pretty weak hair.
Three.
Relative. Look how much this is stretched already.
Oh, that was quick.
That was really quick.
Whoa, okay, so that was...
But then we need to keep going, I feel like. You gotta do those too. Let's keep going. I wonder if all this spinning action is causing some weakness in my hair.
Actually, I think that is possible.
Yeah. I worry that I'm doing a bad job there.
Ooh. Okay, as the horsehair goes next.
I don't know. Oh, these baskets looking pretty full.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, okay.
Every time. Man, this horse hair.
Okay, so I'm gonna add two here. Okay. Oh, nice. Oh, stop it. Nice. Okay. If we line them up, we've got
17, 37.
This is, you counted this one.
88
and 94. Okay,
So definitely, obviously, one hair, super weak.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Then we get to the double hair, 37. That's mm-hmm. a big leap.
It's a big leap. And I'll say, you know, super weak for the single hair, but it still did stretch a tremendous amount before it failed, and that was really cool to see.
Very true.
And the same thing happened with the two hairs together. You almost double the number of, or double the amount of weight that it could sustain to get to a... 37.
Pretty much, yeah, you do.
And then it's more than that. For 37 to 88, it's double. And then the horse hair was the strongest one.
So what happened here? Since these animal hairs are thicker individually, they're usually stronger. But when normalized for diameter, human hair is actually stronger than horse hair. And there's some really cool physics to explain this. In this case, hair thinness is a strength. Hair that's thicker than 200 micrometers tends to snap with what's called a tensile or normal fracture, and leaves behind a clean break. But hair thinner than 200 micrometers tends to break with what's called a shear fracture. Shear fractures have jagged breaks. These breaks are the result of small zigzag cracks forming within the material. In some cases, these materials won't break apart until the cracks meet. Generally, a material that sustains shear fractures can handle greater tension before it breaks. So because thinner hair experiences shear fractures, it can usually handle more tensile stress than thicker hair when normalized for diameter. In other words, if you had four human hairs whose collective diameter was equal to a single horse hair, the four human hairs should be able to hold more weight. Pretty cool.
So we did an experiment to understand just how strong human hair is compared to animal hair, but now we want to zoom in and understand a little bit better what kinds of treatments can affect the strength of your hair. So, you know, does washing your hair change the strength, or does conditioning it? Does doing nothing at all to it matter?
So we have three strands of hair taken from the same person. We have one strand that has been unwashed for 30 days. We have another strand that has been shampooed, and the third one has been shampooed and conditioned. What do you think? Who's gonna win?
You know, if I'm a betting man, and I'm not, but I'm gonna bet, I would say I think the unwashed hair is gonna be the strongest one, because I know that when you wash your hair, or especially if you brush it too much, then it kind of strips that outer layer of the hair, the cuticle, off of it, and that's what kind of produces split ends. So I think that weakens your hair, and I think that maybe that's what you're gonna see with the shampoo. I don't know, what do you think?
You know what, I actually agree with you.
Yeah?
I feel like hair left in its natural state, as it should be, undisturbed, I think it's gonna be the strongest.
Okay, and conditioner? I'm calling that as a wild card. I have no idea what to expect there.
I agree. Also, we don't know what kind of shampoo and conditioners people are using, so who knows?
Right.
I'm gonna go au naturel all the way.
Okay, well, there's only one way to find out.
We think that unwashed, undisturbed is the strongest.
Yeah, I think unwashed, and then I'm gonna say wild card conditioner might do it.
The shampoo, it's gonna break.
It's already stretching the most. You can see it already, it's starting.
Oh yeah, definitely. Definitely in the lead.
Remember the protocol, if it fails, you gotta sweep it out real quick?
Act real quick.
We're close, I think.
Yeah. Real close.
I can't believe this actually works, the science works. It's two, and move this guy out of the way.
Okay.
Just like we predicted.
Just like you predicted.
Yep, the shampooed one dropped first.
Shampoo one dropped first, yeah.
So I guess it might be that you're stripping the cuticle away just like that.
I mean, people tell you that all the time, and yet we still wash our hair all the time.
I don't think people are gonna stop because they like the way it makes their hair look, so maybe it's worth it if you're not trying to hang from your hair for a living or something like that.
I mean, unless you look at this amazing experiment and you see that, wow, it's way weaker than unwashed hair.
That one stretched and broke way faster than the other ones.
It did.
These ones, like that was almost, it was almost maximum length. These ones not even 2/3 of the way that distance yet. Oh, I stand corrected.
Okay, so what's happening now? This is shampoo and conditioner.
Yep.
And this natural guy's still going. Okay,
all right.
We predicted that.
We predicted this,
Well done. However, I am horrified for myself because that means that my hair is probably pretty weak.
Yeah, it might be. So it's really interesting that the shampoo broke first, like we predicted, but conditioner does seem to reverse at least a little bit of that damage based on what we've seen here.
You're right, so it probably moisturized.
Yep.
There we go, okay. Okay, so we're at 44 with this one. This could take almost double the amount of weight as that one.
Yep.
That's substantial.
For the shampoo and conditioner, this one was at 34, so it was about 10 more pennies than just the shampoo. So a little bit of that reinforcement. This one was 44?
Yes, 44. Okay, yeah. So clearly the winner, clearly what we should do, and the takeaway, don't wash your hair.
Okay, so why did this happen? When we shampoo, we don't just remove dirt and grime. We also remove our natural sebum oil, and even lift the cuticle layer a teeny bit, which weakens it. Conditioner replaces the sebum with a protective layer and pushes the cuticle layer back down, making it stronger. In the case of the unwashed hair, it may be dirtier, but it also has a lot of sebum oil protecting it. In theory, this makes it stronger than the shampooed hair, with the unwashed hair even beating out conditioned hair for this test.
All right, Sarika, I know you know what the last matchup has to be.
I knew what it
was
coming down to.
You know this has to be coming. It's my hair versus yours, the ultimate showdown. I'm ready, baby.
Okay, why do you have so much hair in a bag?
Well, this is a lot.
That's a ton of hair. You only need one hair.
I like to be prepared.
Okay. Well, I was minimal on this. I just cut two hairs. But I've been nervous about this for days. I don't know why. It doesn't matter, but I really want to win.
Yeah, well, I think we're both a little bit competitive, so let's do this.
Okay.
Let's throw down. Let me just find the strongest one out of this.
No, you can't do that. What? It's random. Where's my hair?
Three, two, one. I'm fine. Yours is stretching.
I'm getting
17.
Hot. Oh my God.
18. Oh my God.
No.
19.
Come on, don't give out on me
20,
yet.
20. 21.
No, this is too much
22,
pressure.
Oh, you're fading. 23.
Oh my God, Anthony.
24.
I can feel my heart pumping.
25. Oh my no!
Oh my what? God!
What are the odds?
God,
that's hands. Impossible.
Wow, you really pulled.
How is that
me.
Possible?
Oh, thank you.
I never shampoo. Yeah. I never shampoo.
This is the best.
I thought
baggy.
For sure I was gonna win that.
24.
36.
Yeah, okay.
24, 36. And that is, ladies and gentlemen, how you conduct science.
This is the worst day of my life.
Ah, the glory.
Well, congratulations, Sarika. You won.
Thank you. Oh,
what? What do I get?
You get a participation. Thanks for showing up.
Oh my gosh, this actually means quite a bit. I'm surprised.
Oh, congratulations, Sarika. This is rigged. I thought you bleached my hair.
Thanks, Anthony. Thanks, Tim.
You're welcome.
And thanks for watching.
Yeah, thanks for watching. Oh, that was quick. Okay. 15 more takes, Thomas. It's gonna be great. We want.
Watch it.